Ooh, those drums hit nice! Oh, can we appreciate the drum kit on this song? Hello everyone, what is going on? My name is the Newbie Warrior and welcome back to my K-pop reaction channel. I post new K-pop reaction videos here almost every single day. So if you like this video and you want to see more videos just like this one, just go ahead and hit the like button and subscribe button and check out some other stuff on the channel. Today I'm very excited because we are going to be doing the Dream Chapter Eternity. This is the follow-up to the Dream Chapter Magic, which was TXT's last album. I already reacted to Can't You See Me and posted that music video reaction earlier today, so I will not be listing that song as a part of this album reaction, so if you do want to see that, that'll be linked in the description below, I'm excited. I actually really enjoyed Can't You See Me, and from what I remember, the Dream Chapter Magic has a lot of songs that I liked, so I'm hoping that I like a lot of these B-sides as well. Here we go. Starting with Drama. And I remember there being a ton of different genres of music. Ooh. This is like feel good. This is almost like a Pharrell instrumental. Nice, strong, isolated piano chords. I feel like it might do something crazy, though. Okay. I'm waiting for the chorus to drop. That's the chorus. Interesting. It kind of felt anticlimactic to me. The constant shaker is getting annoying. And actually, the repeated chords and drum loops kind of getting annoying, too. I do like this breakdown. But it does lose some impact because these chords of the piano haven't changed the whole time. Then we get really fake brass. Okay, kind of a switch up here. That's nice. That's good to see. Ooh. Okay, the rapper's in his bag. I like the upper vocalist as well, going over him. Yeah, I'm not sure about this song, guys. Way too repetitive for me, I think. Make sure to like Can't You See Me. So I'm not gonna listen to it here. Yeah, I'm gonna be completely honest with you guys. That is probably... No, that's by far my favorite, my least favorite TXT song that I've ever heard. If I look at the few title tracks that I've heard... And, I was like, what's Magic Hour, Japanese versions? The few title tracks that I've heard, and everything, the entirety of Dream Chapter Magic, I think this drama's by far my least favorite song, just from TXT, period. I don't want to hate on it too much, it's just the production felt really simple, the instrumental was extremely, extremely repetitive, even at, like, the choruses, and some of the bridges were the same as the verse instrumental, the brass that they used, the brass samples were some of the worst fake brass I've heard so far this year. Yeah, so no hate towards the group. Oftentimes it's just a production issue, sometimes it's just a songwriting issue, sometimes it's just a budgeting issue. Drama, not a good song in my opinion. I will never intentionally listen to that song again, let me put it that way. It will be perma skipped for me. Okay, but that's one song out of five b-sides. So we got, hey, we could still go 80% songs that I love. So that's what I'm hoping for. On to Fairy of Shampoo, which is a very strange name for a song. Ooh, that's pretty. Wow, that's pretty. The string bass. Nice, pretty single vocalist at a time with the harmony ooze in the background. Wow, that chord that they just hit. Oh, that chord that they just hit. Okay. This is super smooth, like buttery smooth. Ooh, okay. I think I'm liking the song. This has kind of a lonely feel to it in the chorus. Ooh. It's smooth. It's very smooth. See, this brass doesn't sound fake at all. This brass sounds very real. Ooh. We went like R&B for this rap section. The music went from like kind of weird ethereal to like a smooth R&B beat for a bit. This is pretty. Nice held. Sorry guys, I gotta put a cough drop in. My throat's bothering me. Hold on. I wanna hear this whole bridge actually again, sorry. The beat just abruptly stops. for the bridge. It's not a fade or a transition, really. Just a halt. Interesting. This beat is, got some funk to it. It's got an almost disco pulse. Nah, it's too slow to be disco, but it's definitely funk-ish. But then we have the high brass. Like, that's a real horn. Why couldn't we get a real horn for drama? Nice Technicolor. I enjoyed that song. That's nice. Definitely I like it better than Drama. I don't think I like it. Well, I can tell you, I don't like it as much as Can't You See Me. I really like Can't You See Me. I gotta go watch my reaction, like I said, to see how much I like it. Spoiler alert, like the song a lot. Fairy of Shampoo is an interesting one. That's a very unique song. I don't think I've heard anything quite like that, ever. It has a lot of really different elements, to be honest. The kind of dreamy, ethereal floatiness of most of the instrumental. But then we had, like, two elements that didn't fit. We had an almost Disco Fever-type funk bass. And then there was also a lot of brass and horns that were more of like a smooth jazzy vibe, which I think really shone when they went to like the R&B bridge section for the rap verse. Not bridge, it was just an R&B chord progression, I guess, because it wasn't the bridge. Yeah, I really enjoyed that. That's very unique. I still don't think I like it as much as anything on the Dream Chapter Magic, but that song could be a song that grows on me, and I already like it. So yeah, already a very good B-side, so I'm happy. I'm hoping I really like the rest of these as well. Here we go. Maze in the Mirror. Interesting little bit of stylistic auto-tune on the voice. Give it kind of a crispy, longing feel. Ooh. See, this is a constant guitar strumming song. But already there have been, so far there have been switch-ups enough that are interesting that I like it still. Ooh. I like that. This is gorgeous. There's some interesting flourishes on this. Nice way to bring the string bass in. I like this song a lot as well. At its core, it has a simplicity, right? Of an acoustic, softer acoustic song. But then we get these weird switch-ups. Like, bam, 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 bam. And then we'll get, like, a certain vocal line that is like, not really fitting of this type of song normally. Shout out to whoever that is. That's pretty. Sorry, I've not said a lot during this song, chat. I don't know why I said chat, I'm not streaming. I'm just kind of vibing. This is a very pretty, emotional, in your feelings, like, so I've probably just been staring, bopping my head, but especially on a first listen, something like that's very introspective, almost cosmic. It's very beautiful and enchanting. We're gonna give this to, I want to drop this in a playlist. I don't really have one that works. We'll just put this in my new playlist, which is just kind of just a rotation of stuff. This is cool. Maze in the Mirror is a really pretty song. It instantly took me to a very chill and introspective place. It had a lot of repetitive guitar strumming, but not so much that, like, they would always bring in, like, they brought in the bass, then they brought in, like, an interesting vocal line, then they would bring in a beat switch up or take away something. It constantly felt like it was changing, despite being ostensibly the same. I really enjoy that as well. That's my favorite B-side off this. I enjoyed Fairy of Shampoo, but I think I like that song more. That song is I don't know, it just kind of pulls you into it. It's very magnetic and alluring. That's a beautiful song. That is a beautiful, beautiful song. On to Puma, which I expect to be extremely different from that. Yeah. West side, east side. Rap line, maybe? Okay. We're starting like a fire hip hop track. Nice drop in. That's a very playful, like, nah, you can't catch me type of melody. To be singing over this type of, it's an interesting combination. That stutter, the orchestral hit on my right. Like a very dark, almost this song almost feels like you're building power. I try not to mention anime too much in K-pop reactions, because I want to be very clear that if I do reference anime, it's not because of the racial association or the proximity in you know, Japan and South Korea and their similarities in their cultures and things like that. When I mention anime, I want to genuinely mention something that I've noticed. This feels like a montage song of a protagonist that got wrecked, and they're getting some revenge. Either they're getting revenge or they're getting ready to get some serious revenge. This is a dark, brooding hype up song, if that makes sense. I love that sample. That vocal sample's nice. Ooh, those drums hit nice. Oh, can we appreciate the drum kit on this song? This is a dangerous song. I knew the rap line was gonna go off here. This bass is insane. Ooh, that was a very different flow. I like this a lot. This is so dark sounding. Just like some elements of Can't You See Me, actually. Hey, finish with the vocal, why don't you? Okay, before we get into the last track, I love Puma. I know I said Maze in the Mirror is probably my favorite song. Puma is better. I love Maze in the Mirror. Puma is a, like I said, it's a deep, dark, regretful kind of revenge hype up tension building song. It's like determination, but the almost the dark side of being a grinder, right? Almost the dark side, the cost of pushing yourself for something that you want. And it's called Puma. Now I don't have the lyrics up because it's just dropped, and there's no way I'm going to find reliable lyrics that I trust right now in a lyric video. But Puma is a song I might like to see a lyric video for in the future. Because I want to know if my read on the song has anything similar to the lyrics or not. Certainly sonically to me as an English speaker, this sounds very dark and brooding, but almost motivating. In a way that is like, it's scary that it's motivating, right? Like, it's motivating you to do some bad things, you know? Some bad things that you shouldn't do, some petty things, some dirty things. That's what it feels like. This is a revenge motivation song, that's what I'm saying. It sounds dope. I love those dark drums. Oh, the drums. And when they cut them and then and the drums roll back in. Dope. Love the rap line. Lots of different types of flows on here. Really, 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 really like Puma. Like, this one is going on some playlists for a long time, I think. With all that being said, on to Eternally. This is the final song on this album that I've not... Oh, it got really dark! Just like the title track. Oh, it got really, really, really dark. Why did we just get lit up? I just heard a charging handle, and then I just got shot three times. Okay. Eternally. that song is really cool. It's really unique the way that it switches up. It's almost like the song is being corrupted into something evil and sinister and violent. Kind of like the music video for Can't You See Me, which also had the very loud static sound, I feel like. So, yeah. This is cool, though. I really, really, really like Eternity. So, basically, I love everything on this album except Drama, which is okay. It's, hey, oftentimes there's a song that just doesn't vibe with me. Totally okay. There's probably songs that I like on this album that maybe don't connect with some of you. No problems at all. What I will say is that Eternally is incredible. Puma is my favorite. Probably Puma, then Maze in the Mirror, then Eternally? I think so. Those would be my top three B-sides. I can't even rate them compared to the title track, to be honest. Puma is amazing. I love, love, love Puma, and I really like Eternally and Maze in the Mirror as well. Fairy Shampoo is a pretty song that I like. Can't You See Me is incredible, but like I said, obviously not a part of this video. If you want to watch that reaction, that will be linked in the description below. As always, I don't know how you guys feel about this this album. How do you feel it stacks up to Dream Chapter Magic? Which songs did you like? Which songs did you dislike? And did anybody else get absolutely mind blown by Puma and just how dark and edgy and cool it sounds? Anyway, thank you guys so much for watching. My name is the Newbie Warrior. I hope you all have a lovely rest of your day, and please remember to stay newbie. Thank you so much to everyone who has chosen to support me on Patreon, with special gratitude being extended towards CJ, Georgia Young, Lucky7Gen, Bob, and CJ Monasterial.